Hey y'all, it's me, Miss Ashley Ann. Miss Ashley, Tracy is not here with me this morning because I am at work. I'm sitting down in my store, and it's been forever since I've vlogged and watched any vlogs. And this weekend, I was trying to catch up because it slowed down a little since it was Thanksgiving. Thank God. I've been working like a mad woman. So it's Tracy, y'all know she's my sister, and she's also my assistant. I own an interior design and event planning business, and it is Christmas time, so we have been working pretty much till about 4 in the morning. I normally let her go before then because y'all know she has Ron, but I work till about 4 in the morning, go to sleep, get back up at 7, and work again nonstop. I changed my background so you can see some of the stuff that I've been doing, but it's Christmas time, so we decorate offices and homes and stores and just about anything you can think of. We sell mini trees and swags and wreaths and dilly bops and just all kinds of super cute stuff. So my Christmas starts way before Christmas. A lot of my clients want things up before Thanksgiving, and then a lot of the we have two houses and one office left that will be finished this week. I'm so excited. And then I have a big fat glam bar that's coming up Friday, which is going to be amazing. And we have manis and pedis and makeup artists and brows and lashes and hair. And there's a designer here called Inzazikia. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of her, but she's fabulous. And she does the most amazing handbags and cocktail dresses and all that stuff. So that will be hosting at my store on Friday. So I got all the stuff to get done. So last time I talked to y'all, remember I was bitching and complaining and moaning about my roof. Ooh, y'all see that? I just cussed on the Sunday. Bad. Forgive me. Anyway, they fixed my roof. Yay! So excited. Okay, Miss Barganista, I caught up on your vlogs. You look so good, girl. Congratulations on your size 8 and Miller of 709. I saw your fashion shoot. Wow. One day. Hopefully after the first of the year, I'll be there with you guys. So let me tell you why it's been so long that I vlogged. I actually did vlog, like the last time I said I would. Something was up with it, y'all. It would not upload. Would not. It would upload to private, and then when I tried to share it with my friends and my subscribers, it still would not allow me. So there's something about that vlog. Obviously, for some reason, the universe doesn't want me to put it up. But in it, I talked about my weight loss. Well, my weight training routine that I was about to start, and I showed Bertha, and I'd also posted some pictures so people could see the difference between P1 when I started that first week, and then of course y'all know I ended a little early because my body just it became immune to the HCG and it quit taking, so I went ahead and moved into P3 about a week and a half early. So I will say this: I have been stable the whole time. This is wrapping up the end of my 3 weeks, and I gained 1.5 pound back, and I really think a lot is because I had poor water consumption, but that was it. And I will be honest with y'all, either I did not really stay on the protocol for P3. I didn't go all the way completely off, but y'all know I was having issues with my bowel movements. Well, one day I ate a carb. It wasn't a lot. I haven't been eating like tons and tons of carbs, nothing like that. I've been, staying away from the potatoes and the rice and all that stuff. But like let's say I had pizza one day and I made pizza and I ate one slice of the crust and the rest of the pizza, like I just ate the top. So basically I piled like another pizza top on top of that and I had that one slice in my big old salad. Make my own ranch dressing now since we can have that. Italians, all my vinaigrettes and all that stuff. The protocol has really changed, I guess, my taste buds. Y'all know I used to be a big Taco Bell head before, and I really don't eat much fast food anymore. So, oh, and this is gonna be long, just FYI, in case y'all wanna know, because it's been forever since I vlogged, and I miss y'all so much, and I'm just trying to think of everything I can to update with. Hopefully, I'll be shooting another vlog, like, in the next couple of days. I'm trying to get back on track since I'm slowing back down and going back to more of a normal work schedule. Anyway, sorry, sidetrack. P3 was challenging for me when I first started because I was afraid to eat anything because YouTube was going so well. So about the first week, I had miracle noodles. I tried like a pasta bake, and I made my own tomato sauce and did turkey in it for the meat and all that good stuff. And I had some cheese because I love cheese, so I was excited about that. Yay, cheese! I did the miracle noodles. The miracle noodles are good. Well, the thin ones, the angel hair, the thin pasta, those are good. The other ones I really didn't care for too much. It's like too much of it at one time or something. Like they have a lasagna, a tortilla, and all that stuff. Ugh, gross. Save y'all the trouble. Also, oh, I can't remember who it was, but she came and commented about the noodles because I was freaked out because I had eaten well all week, and then I had this noodle. And I gained a pound, and I couldn't figure out what the hell was going on. She was like, well, you have to have extra water, because if you don't, the noodles will make you gain. So if you eat the miracle noodles, they're good, but, yeah, drink lots of water, or you'll gain. So what I tell y'all? Okay, measure my inches. Everything was the same up until this week for Thanksgiving. And y'all know how I do. When I cheat, I don't believe in just cheating today. I'm going to cheat the whole weekend. Like, I make it a whole ordeal party. It's, you know, going to make it happen, make it do what it do. So, but I'm also on Tom. Tom came 2 days ago, and I blow really bad when Tom is here. So, other than my measurements, none of them have changed except for I actually gained a quarter of an inch around my waist. And I don't know if that's from Thanksgiving food, or if it's from bloating from tongue. So I will let y'all know at the end of the week which one it is, because I'll be back to normal by then. As far as the working out, I started working out really, really great. It only lasted for 3 days because, like I told y'all, I work from 4 in the morning. I get up at 7 and work from 7 in the morning to 4 the next morning and go back to sleep. And I wish I could say I was exaggerating, but I'm not. So I have not been sleeping well. I have not been eating well. I'm not eating like junk food and stuff, but let's say it may be 10 o'clock at night before I eat, and I'm just being honest, and I know that's bad. You know, I may grab a grapefruit in the morning, and then at 10 at night, you're tired, so you don't cook, so I pretty much eat egg whites with spinach in them, throw some cheese and tomatoes, and whatever random meat I can find, whether it's chicken breast, pepperoni, whatever is there. That's what I take, and I put it in my egg whites, and that and mug bread. What else? I mean, I've been cheating here and there, but it's a lot of stuff I just can't eat. Like when Thanksgiving came, y'all, I didn't eat a lot. I only ate a spoonful of everything, but I got horribly, horribly, horribly sick. So I think it was more the sugar than the butter, because I've been eating tons of whipped cream too since I started P3. Because I love cream, so I've been making cream and cream cheese to make like a mousse, and then I flavor it however. So if I want chocolate mousse, I do, you know, the Truvia, some cocoa powder, the heavy whipping cream, and about a fourth of a block of cream cheese, so what, maybe 2 ounces of cream cheese, something like that, and I whip it all together, and it makes a fantabulous mousse and a fantabulous dessert, and it's a good way to get my calories in. So, you know, I've been pretty much having stuff like this. I don't think it was really the fat at Thanksgiving. I think it was too much sugar, because I made a traditional New York style cheesecake. I made a Reese's cheesecake. It's amazing. It's chocolate and peanut butter, uber rich. You can only have like a teeny tiny slice or you will die. With a sweet potato surprise and a cranberry pecan cake, banana pudding, you know, Reese's brownies, all the sweet stuff. And I only ate teeny, teeny, tiny pieces of all of them, but it was just too much for me to handle. I had dressing, I had a tiny piece of ham, small Italian meatballs, the baked potato salad, only a little spoon. I mean, y'all, I was like, oh, I'm gonna max out. It's balls to the wall. I do shit. So, anyway, I'm nervous about stepping on the scale, though, because, of course, if I was eating off Thursday, I ate off Friday, and yesterday and today. What did I eat yesterday? I went to Red Mango. I love Red Mango. I don't know if y'all have them, but it's like a yogurt shop, and it's gluten-free and all-natural, and they use Greek yogurt, and it's fantabulous. So that's what I had, and Red Mango, anytime I've ever cheated, I was going to get Red Mango. It does not make me sick. So like I said, I told y'all before, I have a theory, like processed food, like our bodies can't handle it anymore, but if it's like actual, real, natural, your food, we can take it. So my red mango was great. I had something that was bad though. I went and got a McRib because I love the McRib. I know that it's not real. I know it's some weird foreign mystery meat. I don't give a damn. I love McRib, y'all. So I went and had a McRib. Only ate it with one piece of the bread because I'm not a big bread eater anyway. And y'all, I only ate a fourth of my fry. Can you believe it? I was such a fry junkie. There were some times I would just go to McDonald's and order fries and just have fries for dinner. I only ate a fourth. I gave half to my other assistant who was with me. And then out of that half, I only ate half of them. So I had a fourth of fries and a McRib sandwich without one of the buns. And water to drink. I haven't been really, I had a glass of apple juice one day. It was natural organic stuff or whatever. And I love V8, V-Fusion, so not the Fusion, the V8. Yeah, it's V-Fusion, not the one with the sugar in it, the one that's actually made with vegetables and fruits, and that's it. I used to drink that even before I started the protocol. So I've had a couple glasses of that, and that's it. My bowel movements have gotten back on track, so I think I have to have a little bit of carb. But anyway, I know this is really long. That's about it with me and eating, but it works, y'all. I didn't try and do the extended days. I've stabilized fine. Now, I will have to let you know what the hell is going on the scale on Monday. I will write that weight down because I said I think I'm going to start keeping them on track like once a week. I'm terrified to get on the scale Monday because I know I've been so bad this weekend, so there's no telling what the fuck it's going to say. So, yeah, I may talk about it. I may write it down, but it will be there. Also, at the end of this vlog, I don't know if I mentioned it, but I'm going to post the pictures that I tried to post on my last one so you can see the difference in between, you know, when I started day one on P1 and then I ended up doing 30-something days. I had it written down somewhere, but I lost it. But, I mean, you can see.